Well, the water in Lake Tahoe has flipped. That's according to research data gathered by the UC Davis Tahoe Environmental Research Center. That means that water that was at the lake surface is now down at the bottom and vice versa. And the temperature of that water is basically the same from top to bottom. This is something that hasn't happened since 2019. Let's take a look at what's going on. Bitter cold air that's in contact with the water cools the very top layer. Now, if the air stays cold, more and more cold water builds up and eventually it starts to sink. Now, this process slows down during periods of warmer weather, but this entire winter has been very cold. South Lake Tahoe has been about 7 degrees colder than average since November 1st. So these plumes of frigid lake water, well, they were all able to sink all the way down to the bottom this year. In an average year, that mixing stops at about 1,000 feet down, and Lake Tahoe is about 1,600 feet deep. Dr. Jeff Slatto is the director of the UC Davis Tahoe Environmental Research Center. He says this complete mixing has big benefits for the lake system.
Balance, it's a good thing. The bottom of the lake slowly loses oxygen because of decomposition of all the organic material that falls at the bottom. So if we didn't have mixing, we would eventually run out of oxygen at the bottom of Lake Tahoe.
And that oxygen feeds microorganisms on the lake floor. Nutrients also get redistributed when the water is mixed like this. There's also been a dramatic change in the clarity of the lake water. Contrary to what you may think, the clearest water in the entire system is actually down at the very bottom. So when the lake is mixed, that water gets brought to the surface. Lake clarity from the surface is typically at about 60 to 70 feet. Earlier this week, it was at 115 feet. But Schlatto says once the weather warms up and dries out, that'll change.
What's going to happen now is that as snowmelt starts to occur and we get sediments washing into the lake as water temperatures warm and we get algae growing, both those factors are going to decrease that clarity. So we expect it maybe to stay high for the next few weeks, but then to revert down again.
And the UC Davis Tahoe Environmental Research Center is preparing to release lake clarity data from all of last year. We'll be on the lookout for that in the next couple of weeks, but Dr. Schlatto has hinted that the news there is pretty good too. Back to you.